station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground, I'm Isidro Reyna. This week, a Russian cargo craft departed the International Space Station. The Progress 74 resupply ship was packed with trash and obsolete gear before it undocked from the station on July the 8th. The vehicle had been attached to the orbiting laboratory since December 9, 2019, bringing nearly 3 tons of food, fuel, and supplies for the station's residents. After separating from the station, the Progress fired its deorbit engines over the South Pacific and burned up safely in the Earth's atmosphere. Progress 76, the next cargo ship to replenish the crew, is scheduled to launch on July the 23rd and dock to the station just 2 orbits later. The Expedition 63 crew stayed busy this week conducting a habitability test of the Crew Dragon Endeavour. Doug Hurley and Bob Behnken performed a series of tests to verify Crew Dragon's features and functions while in orbit around Earth, including opening and closing the hatch, operating Dragon's waste system, donning their spacesuits, and moving cargo back into the vehicle. They were also joined by 2 more crew members to test Dragon's sleeping configuration, to assess the spacecraft, and determine what improvements could be made for future crews. The Demo 2 mission is the final major step before NASA's Commercial Crew Program certifies Crew Dragon for operational, long-duration missions to the space station. This certification and regular operation of Crew Dragon will enable NASA to continue the important research and technology investigations taking place on board the station, which benefits people on Earth and lays the groundwork for future exploration of the Moon and Mars. This week's question comes from Chris. He wants to know how many people the International Space Station can hold at any given time. The space station has been continuously occupied since November 2000. International crews up to 6 people have lived and worked on the station, but with the dawn of the Commercial Crew Program, that total will likely increase. The living and working space in the station is larger than a 6-bedroom house, and for now has 6 sleeping quarters, 2 bathrooms, a gym, and a 360-degree view bay window. The record for the largest population on station was set in 2009, when 13 astronauts and cosmonauts were on board. Keep sending in your questions using the hashtag AskNASA. We'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.